Sherry Show. Today I have a special guest, Alexis. Alexis, she's my best friend's daughter. Camelia, my daughter, and Alexis, they grew up together. You see the pictures. Magic, can you put the little picture for them to see?
Here you are.
There you go. And then, so Alexis for me says, Sherry, I want to cook with you. And I said, I would love that. Yeah. Say hi, Alexis. Introduce yourself.
Hello, everyone. I'm Alexis. Yep.
And what are you going to do for us?
We are going to make Thai green curry with chicken. Yeah. So let's cook together.
There you go. Yeah.
An orange bell pepper, we've got some eggplants, broccoli, carrots. Here we've got some rice that's been soaking and some chicken thighs. And we also have some cremini mushrooms, ginger, garlic, a sweet yellow onion. And then we'll also be using some green curry sauce, salt and pepper, and a little bit of paprika.
And what's this butter for?
Oh, that's for our rice, so it gets extra good.
And what is this?
This is some coconut milk. Can't forget that.
All right, yes. Perfect. So let's do it.
Okay.
Okay, what are we doing?
All right, so first we're gonna start with our ginger and garlic and onion and cut that up. So okay. We're gonna grab a piece of it, get a good sized chunk, maybe about half of that.
Perfect. There.
Save that for later. And so we'll start by peeling it, getting the skin off.
Oh, I forgot to say, you guys, Alexis loved to cook, and she started cooking when she was 12 and 13 years old. Right, Alexis?
Yeah, about that time. Yep. Yeah, so we're just getting all the skin off so that we can chop up the good stuff.
Perfect.
Something like that. Get rid of that, and then we're just going to chop this up real fine. So get your slices, and then you're gonna grab them and just get them into smaller chunks.
Alexis, you recently moved to Vancouver. She's an artist. She actually paints and she draws a very nice pictures. And then tell a little bit about yourself, Alexis.
Yeah, so I grew up here out in BC, and I went to Toronto where I studied for graphic design. But yeah, I've been painting my whole life, and anything creative, cooking included, I love to do.
There you go. That's my Lex.
Yeah. All right, so we got our ginger. Oh, one more piece. You can use about that, and then we need some garlic, of course. I'm gonna peel it. Get a few cloves. If you love your garlic, you can add a little bit more, but I would say at least 4 or 5.
Perfect. Oh, don't cry.
Oh, poor my baby.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Oh. Alright, so everything here, I'm just gonna go in your pan.
Okay. Just gonna put that in. Oh, at the same time.
At the same time.
You put everything at the same time.
Yeah. Perfect.
So this, how much olive oil?
About a tablespoon. And then we're gonna turn it on to about medium high.
Oh, this side, this one. Yeah. Medium side, okay.
Yep. And get these going. Mix them all together. Mm-hmm. We're just gonna wait until the onion goes a little bit translucent.
Like a golden color? Or?
Yeah, and gets aromatic. So
mm-hmm.
Now we're gonna make sure our rice gets going because it's gonna take some time to cook. So we've already let it soak for a bit. We're gonna have to drain it and put it in the water, which we've got going boiling.
Did you already put salt in there?
Of course.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
It's my girl, you guys. Hey.
All right. So. Drain our rice. Okay. Mm-hmm. And then we're gonna go and we're gonna put it into our pot. We're gonna get this going in here. So we got 3 cups of rice and 6 cups of boiling water, 2 to 1. We're gonna add just a little bit of butter to the pot. Let it melt in as it cooks. And about a tablespoon of that.
Why do you put butter in there?
It makes the rice just taste great.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Comes out fluffy and creamy and good.
Sorry, I was just cleaning up for you.
Well, thank you. Every you kitchen needs a helper.
Yeah. I'm your little helper today.
Yes.
Okay, so what's next?
All right, so now we need to do the eggplant. I always like to cook these separately from the rest of the pan because they need to be cooked at just the right amount, not too much, not too little. Mm-hmm. And if you fry them, then they...
So you previously wash your eggplant?
Yes.
Yeah.
Wash them, take off the ends.
Mm-hmm.
And then these nice skinny ones are great because you get discs where you cut them
into
discs.
And they're sweet, right?
Yeah, they're sweet.
Mm-hmm.
And the skin is all the way around each slice, so they stay together nicely. So you're gonna cut them into about quarter inch slices.
Mm-hmm.
All the way down.
And then you fry them later?
Yeah, so we're gonna just fry them in olive oil, salt, and pepper. Nothing much more. Let the flavors of the eggplant
comes out itself.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah.
You know, Alexis, eggplant is one of my favorite dishes.
It's so good.
Yeah.
There's so much you can do with it if you know
exactly.
how to cook it properly.
Exactly.
It's really good.
Yeah. I love eggplants. I remember when you were a kid, you didn't like eggplants.
It was the one thing I didn't like. I
remember
was
that.
Not picky, but eggplant.
But now you do.
I do because I know how to cook it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When Alexis was a little, she was always come to my house. She used to call me Auntie Sherry at that time. She was so little. She says, Auntie Sherry. She used to say, Auntie Sherry, can you cook for me? And I used to cook for her.
Yeah.
Her favorite dish was kebab at that time.
Yes. And saffron rice. I talk about
saffron rice
all the time. Yeah. Eggplant tends to soak it up a lot, so I would put a little bit more than I think.
And it's okay to put olive oil instead of the vegetable oil?
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, olive oil, it just has great flavor.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's gonna get a little bit hot, and then we're gonna put this eggplant in.
So let's cheers with our tea.
Yeah.
This is a Persian tea that we made together.
So good, yeah.
Mm.
Yeah, so far so good. It's starting to smell good in here.
Yeah,
yeah.
I can smell already everything. I'm getting hungry.
I know, soon. Thankfully, it's not a very lengthy dish to cook, so.
Yeah.
All right.
How long would this take for us to cook the whole dish and then start eating?
It would take about maybe an hour at the most, probably less.
Mm-hmm.
So you're gonna put them in there.
Okay, just like that.
Yeah.
So you're really not frying them, you're sauteing them, right?
Yeah, well, yeah, you're not deep frying them.
Deep frying them, yeah.
Yeah, the direct heat, you can do them in the oven too, but they can dry out a bit.
Exactly. I don't like to put the eggplants in the oven too because it just dries out the juice of the eggplant.
Yeah, but if you want a quick workaround, if you want it to speed up the process, you could. But the direct heat does well for making the eggplant. So you want to try and get as much directly on the pans, just spread them out.
Yeah. We're like doctor and nurse today. Do you need this today?
Yeah, hand me the tongs.
The tongs were later, right?
Perfect, yeah. So now we're going to make sure we get our salt and pepper and sprinkle that on. Are already steamed on the rice, so we're just gonna bring the temperature down to
two
or so.
Yeah.
Just let it finish off.
Okay,
it's
can
looking
I
good.
See what it's look like?
Yeah.
Now? Oh wow.
Yeah. So
okay.
We're doing good.
Nice.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's still some water in there, but it's quite reduced. So.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Perfect.
And now these eggplants, we're just watching them and see when the skin gets brown like that and the purple starts to fade, that's a good sign.
Mm-hmm.
And
I can smell it, my goodness.
Yeah, so that piece is done. You see it's golden on the side, so
we
can
take
that
off
the pan.
And I can smell your eggplant.
I know, good aromas going around.
I know.
Yeah, so we got our eggplant cooked, we've got our onion and our garlic and our ginger in the pan. So now that it's getting a little bit warm and translucent and aromatic, we need our chicken. So we're gonna take our chicken thighs,
mm-hmm.
and we need to cut them into some bite-sized chunks.
Mm-hmm.
So.
How much chicken are you using?
We're using about a pound of chicken today.
A pound of chicken. Mm-hmm. So you're frying your chicken with your onions and...
Yeah, get it going first.
Garlic and ginger.
We're gonna have to wash this. Mm. Right, so now we got the everything in here. We're just gonna stir it up and let this chicken fry up on medium-high heat. And while it's doing that, we're gonna get our veggies ready. Vegetables, we wanna do them in order of how hard they are. So we're gonna do our carrot first, and then our broccoli, and then our bell pepper last, and our mushrooms last. So, we gotta peel our carrot first. Now that the chicken no longer has any pink showing, we're gonna just add some salt and pepper, about half a teaspoon of each again, maybe a little more on the salt. And if you have green curry paste, you can also use it to fry with the chicken, if you have it on hand. And then this is some paprika, so we're just gonna add a little bit of that too. Before we add the vegetables.
Have a little kick on it, right?
Of course.
We need that kick.
Yeah. Now that this chicken is seasoned and pretty cooked, it's all brown, we're gonna add our hard vegetables, so the broccoli and the carrot.
Because of the onions and ginger and the garlic that we put in there, we don't need to put a lot of the spices in there.
No,
because of their own ingredients, you know, it's gonna come out and...
And the green curry itself has a lot of flavor, so
yeah,
you're good there. You can start to fry up.
It looks great, Alexis.
Yeah, lots of great color.
Yeah.
So while those cook, we're gonna move on to our softer vegetables. So, so we got our mushrooms. We get a handful of these. Mushrooms cook down quite a bit, so.
So you put them at last.
Yeah, they we do. And it might look like a lot once you slice them up, but they sure shrink in the pan. And now we're gonna get our bell pepper, so we're just gonna slice it, slice the sides off, get rid of the middle.
You only need the sides. And
then we're just gonna slice these long into
like a spaghetti-y cuts. So you don't overcook them, basically.
Yeah, you want to put things in at different times so that
you don't overcook things.
When you get to the end, everything's cooked just soft, but not too too soft, So looking at these, the carrots are starting to get soft, but they're still not quite done, and the broccoli is nice and green.
Wow.
So that means that we're ready for the rest of our vegetables.
Well, there we go.
So grab them. Add them in. We used an orange bell pepper. You're welcome to use yellow or red or green as well, but yeah, like the...
Well, that's because you have already different colors in there.
Yeah.
That's why you choose orange.
Yeah, orange is nice and sweet too, but not as mild as a yellow pepper, so... That's why it's my favorite choice. Yeah. So look at that. Now we've got, see, a little bit of mushrooms, a little broccoli.
Yeah.
Add it all together and you get quite a bit of food.
So if let's say we got our vegetarian audiences.
Yeah.
They just want to make this. They just don't add the chicken.
Just don't add the chicken, and you can welcome to add more veggies of your choice too if you want to. But as you can see, we've got a lot. So yeah, it's very easy to accommodate a vegetarian preference. So you don't want to wait too as much time for once you have the other vegetables in, because they're going to cook in the sauce, and that's what we're going to do is we're going to first add
and you don't want to over fry your veggies.
So we are just going to add 1 can of coconut milk.
That's like 2 cups.
Yeah, about that. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to add our green curry sauce. So add that in there.
Oh, yum. Is that a spicy or?
There's a little bit of spice to it, but it's usually pretty reasonable.
Not, so it's not like spicy hot.
No. Yeah. All right, so sauces are in there. Let's just stir it up. Now we're gonna bring it down to medium low.
Oh my goodness, it looks so creamy.
Mm-hmm.
And I see different colors of vegetables in there.
Yep.
Wow. I can smell that aromatic smell coming out.
Yeah, and then we're good to go because our rice is done. So now that this is looking good and done, you add the eggplant in just at the very last. So, so that's in there, but oh, look at that.
Mm.
And we're good to go. So now we're just gonna plate our dishes up.
Wow. So show us how you're gonna plate our dishes. Here you have it, you guys. What was this dish again?
Thai green curry with chicken.
There
Doesn't
you
it look
go.
Great?
Oh my goodness, let's taste it. I'm so hungry.
I know, I can't wait.
Okay, so there's a little bit of eggplant in there.
Yeah, that's not bad.
Let's dance.
Yeah.
So
happy
good.
Food dance.
Happy
food
dance. Yum. Look at this. The vegetables are so crunchy, and yet they're cooked well.
They're soft, yeah.
I hope you guys like this dish, and I hope you guys make it. Once you make it, send a picture to us.
Yes, please do.
Yes. But until next time, cheers. Thanks for watching, you guys. If you like this video and you want to see more, please subscribe the channel and leave a comment below. I love to read your comments.